Good morning, ladies. Happy Saturday. I am just going to give you a real quick, I have a busy Saturday ahead of me with clients, and I am just going to do a real quick application on my foundation and my blush so that you can see that this is super easy. You don't have to do a lot of work to get it applied. All I have on my face right now is my Climate Control. Love it. Keeps us young and beautiful. So I have my Climate Control on and I have a little bit of Silk. And that way it minimizes all the pores, a little bit of any of the wrinkles or anything that are kind of bothering you. And let me get my glasses off. And my foundation that I use is our anti-aging, which I love. It gives a moist, dewy feel to my skin. I don't need a lot of my day cream because of it. And so I just have a little tiny bit of my normal to dry day cream on my skin. And with my foundation, I use Fawn. And very easy to always figure out which color would be best for you, or if you're trying to work with a client and come up with the best foundation color for them, kind of take your colors, take some of the samples that you think you have that might be close, take it from the skin on the face down past the jawline to the neck. That way it gives you a nice even tone of the different areas of the face and neck and décolleté that actually show out to your audience. So if once you let that sit for just a minute or so, put on two or three different colors that you think might work, put it on, and then the one that disappears the most, the one that really blends, that's the one you go with. So for me, it's Fawn. So sometimes I take a palette, sometimes I use the back of my hand, sometimes I just use my fingers. You do whatever works for you best because you want to be quick and you want to be able to get it applied very easily and quickly to start your day. So I have just a couple of squirts of my foundation. Now I like to apply mine with a stipple brush. I've got heavier ones and then I have a smaller one. This is our Cenegence and comes in our makeup brush kit. And so use the ones that work best for you. Everyone's contours are different and everyone has a brush that feels better to them. So just use the one that feels best for you. I stipple down. Okay, just kind of get some on your brush. Now stippling kind of works like pixels work for your camera. You know, the more pixels that you have, the higher dollar your phone and your camera. But it gives you a much prettier look. So if you're getting someone camera ready, we would always suggest to probably go ahead and do the stippling version. That way you put on thousands and thousands of little dots all over the skin and just get it kind of blended in. Don't forget neck and décolleté down in these areas, because remember you've got a 15 SPF in there. So that's gonna really help you throughout the day and not have to worry about all this hot heat, of which we are in our 90s and 100s here in Oklahoma. So we need all the Cenegence skincare and makeup we can get on our face. Love it. Now, if you want a softer look, then take your stipple or a foundation brush of choice, and you can kind of, I'm gonna just look in the mirror just a little bit to make sure I've kind of got it spread around. Do a real soft, just over all of it, all the areas that you put, all of your foundation, whether it's the original formula or the anti-aging formula. And you know, I always suggest anti-aging if they're over 30. That's just what I do. You know, it's after those 20s that our skin begins to age a little. And so I always suggest, if they ask me, I always suggest the anti-aging if they're over 30. So just a suggestion, because moisture changes. Make sure you don't have any demarcations right in the jaw area. You don't want to look like you have a mask on. So just make sure everything gets really well blended. Kind of look in your little mirrors if you see anything that maybe did not get blended correctly. Ta-da! Beautiful. I just love it. And it just feels so good. Okay, now, quickly also, on the blush scents, terracotta, toasted rose. I like to mix them both a lot. So I am going to take just a little drop of each down on my palette. That's why I'm looking down. So I'm going to put a little bit of each. And then you can take your fingers, you can take the back of a brush, whatever you want to do, and go ahead and mix them up. Blend them out. And then what I do, make your little apples. You like my... I know. I need more coffee, I think. And then I put a little bit on my ring finger, softest touch. Spread it. Just kind of tap them together so that I get even amounts on both sides. Make my little apples. You don't want to go more than any closer to your nose than halfway of your little eyeball. So, dot, dot, and then kind of take it in a C. This can help you, especially if you're new. Now, we're not doing contouring. Contouring can kind of come down. It can work with a lot of chiseling and a little bit lower in the areas, but just where you think the sun would come down and kind of blush your cheeks. That's kind of what you, the way you think about it. So I just do that. Always rub my scented gents in. Anything left over, I just rub it in because it just feels so good. Okay, and then I take another one of my stipple brushes. This one's a little bit stiffer, one of my faves. And then I kind of roll on real light. Now I'm not really pressing in. I'm just barely touching it, barely going over it, and then kind of run it up and blend it in. You don't want any big marks and you don't want a big dot on your cheeks, okay? So just kind of do that. You can always hit the top of your nose. Show you like this a little bit closer. Blend it in. This is a super light touch. You guys, this goes on cream, you notice that, but it turns into powder. So it turns into powder just as you start working with it. So any of you that have ever been used to using powder makeups or shadows and all of those kind of things, this will turn into powder as you begin working with it. So it makes it super easy. Boom, boom, boom. Okay, there's our foundation. I've got anti-aging on with in Fawn and terracotta and toasted rose blush on me. And if I'm doing something a little brighter or I want a bigger look, I might go to cherry. You can always add your pearlizer, which gives it that fun little J-Lo glow. And that is always fantastic. I wanted to show you real quick just a little trick also on Foops. We've been having lots of things on all of our pages about Foops and things like that. But this is just a little thing that I do for my clients. Every time I have a climate control and I'm finished with it, whether it's out of my demo kit or my personal, I save these little caps. Okay, so I just take these off. Okay, so I've got one, and I do have one actually that is finishing up here. I take these off, I clean them out, I rinse them off. I take my Foops. This removes all that color technology. You might think your 3-in-1 cleanser or another makeup remover is just gonna do it, but you've got to break down that technology in our amazing products. It has to be able to get itself out of your pores, make sure that you don't have any residue on your skin. So what I do is I take a little orange wood stick because I have a nail and makeup studio, so I always have orange wood sticks around, and I just go into that little piece, that little cap, and then I remove it, OK? Okay, so you can remove it. I take this, I put it right on in, screw it on. This is, remember, from my climate control. Ta-da, okay? Shake it up, spritz it on. Works amazing. And what I also do is I keep all of them, like I said, all of these caps, rinse it off, and then I attach it to my FOOPs, and I sell them this way. So that way they've got an automatic little sprayer if they'd like to do it that way. Those that travel, make sure that they keep their caps, because I travel a lot, so I know. And keep those caps on. Always great to have that so that it doesn't have all the leaking and things. Sometimes a spray can leak when you're traveling, depending on elevations. So that's just another little tip. I will do eyes and lips later, and you guys have an amazing Saturday. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.